So Pretier is ready, and the next step is to actually launch the Cypress for the first time and also to modify the Cypress JSON. So let's do it. Well, you have basically two options. First, you can create a script. This is a very typical convention. And you will create a script, cyopen. And here you want to call Cypress open. And then you would go to the terminal and you would do npm run cyopen and it would open the Cypress. Or if you want to use npx, you can just use npx and then run this command. So npx Cypress open. So if I hit enter, it will now open the Cypress without the need of using the scripts from package.json. And let me pull it to my second screen. As you can see, our Cypress is ready. Our folders have been created, and also there is end package JSON, Cypress JSON. So let's open it, and I'm gonna close this. And now we need to fill some configuration. So first is video, because we don't need to actually create videos of these files. So I'm gonna set it to false, but again, it's optional. If you want, you can set it to false. And I can recommend you using videos in your production tests, but for this tutorial purposes, it's no need to use videos. Second is default command timeout. And I want to set it to 5 seconds. Then we want to specify the page load timeout. And page load timeout is typical to be around 10 seconds, so we can leave it at 10. And then there is one specific thing I need to do, and that is ignore test files. Ignore test files. And I want to specify everything with .js and md. Because if you leave this and you will not ignore files with JS, you will have a lot of JavaScript step definition files in your Cypress application, because we are using Cucumber and we will be running files as features. So we don't need the JS files, because JS files were only storing page objects and step definitions, and all the test files will have a suffix of feature. So to make it consistent, we need to ignore it in this Cypress JSON. And last step I want to do is go back to the script and let's add one more script. And let's name it cy_test. And we want to specify the Cypress run command. Again, you can run it from the npx, but just to make it again more stable, we can leave it here just to make sure that we are following both standard patterns. So I think we are ready and we can move on.